Hello, in this presentation we're going to be talking about the algebra of propositions. And a lot of times we will use the algebra of propositions when we want to algebraically show a particular statement is maybe a tautology, or perhaps if we have a statement and we want to simplify it. Now, we can always work with truth tables, but if we're asked to work with the algebra of propositions, then that requires some different strategies. So here's our claim, and the claim that we want to prove is that if not P, then if P then Q is a tautology. So we have a conditional, and the conclusion there of the conditional is another conditional. So it's a little bit complicated, but we want to do is simplify this, and in simplifying it, we want to ultimately show it's a tautology. Now, one general strategy for working on these sorts of questions is to replace this if-then sort of statement with something simpler, like an and statement or an or statement. So we're going to go in here and attack this arrow, this conditional statement. So to attack that, what we want to do is we want to recall the following. We have a logical equivalence, which we could prove with a truth table or something, and that goes like this. It says if P, then Q. That's equivalent to not P or Q. And you could kind of, convince yourself that this is true, or work it out with the truth table. So let's begin here with our proof, and again our first line of attack is to replace this conditional statement with something that's going to be simpler. So our recollection here of this equivalence would say we can replace this conditional statement with a disjunction or an or statement. So this is going to be equivalent to, well, whatever the hypothesis was, I'm supposed to negate that. So it's going to be not P. And then instead of the arrow, we've got the or. So there's simplifying our statement. And then whatever came after that arrow, in other words, whatever was the conclusion, we just are going to copy that over. And we'll deal with that on the next line. Okay, so this is good. Things are getting simpler for us, and we're working down towards our goal. Now, one thing we can immediately do is say not P. Well, that's just going to be P. That's double negation. So we can simplify that. And now again, we're going to go in here and attack this conditional statement, replacing that with our disjunction. So we'll come in here and say this is equivalent to not P or Q. And now by associativity, you know, these are all or statements here. So when you have a bunch of or statements, it doesn't really matter where the parentheses go. That's the associativity property. So we can essentially drop those or reorganize those parentheses. We can regroup if we want, however you want to think about that. And so what we get is here, P or not P? Well, one of those is going to be true. So since one of them is true, that's all we need for this or statement to be true. So we've narrowed it down to the following, something that's true or Q. And again, by this absorption law, as soon as one of them is true, the whole thing is true. And so what this shows is that our original statement is always true, and that's the definition of a tautology.